Baseball Weekly Update. Tyler Merriam joined by the head coach, Rob Bishop of South Dakota State, and the rare out-of-conference May baseball series for the Yellow and Blue. Don't talk about this very often, but you did it. West Lafayette, Indiana against Purdue. And you lose 2 out of 3, and yet, knowing everything you've been through, the long trip, I thought you competed very well. Am I wrong?
No, I thought we played well, really, in all three games. The Friday game, we made just a couple of, they weren't really errors, but just kind of untimely mistakes. But our offense showed up. We scored 7 runs on Friday and 7 runs on Saturday against a good pitching staff, and really had a chance to win on Sunday too until late, and that one kind of slipped away from us. But I was happy with how we competed, especially as thin as we are currently, and guys did a good job, and we got to play in a really good environment, highly competitive environment, which is exactly what we need going into tournament time.
Talk about guys on the mound, and we've been talking about starting pitching, and when it's been there, you've been very good, and it certainly was this past weekend. Blake Koons gets his first win as a Jackrabbit, obviously the transitioning player from football to baseball. Really cool to see him. And although Jake Goble doesn't get a win, 7 innings of one hit ball without giving up an earned run, I mean, he's been excellent.
Yeah, I mean, both those guys, Jake and Blake, were fantastic this weekend, kind of showed. In Koons' case, he's just gotten better and better as the season's gone on, which you would expect after having the long layoff without baseball. And he's a terrific athlete and a great worker. And we're really excited to see him down the stretch here. And Goble, you've seen him several times this year. When he's right, he's tough to beat. So, I like where we're at right now. We need a little bit more consistency out of that third spot, but Arbogast has been good. Will Kent's been good in the midweek. So, and as always, I still really like our bullpen. We've got a bunch of guys down there throwing the ball well. So, if we can just continue to have some consistency on the pitching side, I think we're going to be fine.
Drew Beasley has 4 hits, including 2 that go for extra bases. Reese Anderson really jumps out to me, though, moving him up to the leadoff spot without McDonald. He has 6 hits, including a double. What a great way to set the table for you, the way he's been swinging the bat.
Yeah, and even more than how he's been swinging the bat is just how he's been competing. Even the bats that haven't ended well, he's hit a lot of balls hard. He's just given us great at-bats to start off games or start off innings. And he was the guy that was kind of turning the lineup over for Mac and all of those guys. And with Ryan going down, it was, rather than shifting everybody around, it made sense just to move one guy. And Reese was excited to get that opportunity. He did a really good job this weekend.
All right, so 2 weeks left in the regular season. You haven't officially cemented yourself into the Summit League tournament, but certainly in a very good position. A chance to do that this week and against a team that you dropped 2 out of 3 to seemingly 3 years ago, but it was just 6-7 weeks ago out in Colorado as you face Northern Colorado. Senior weekend, just a lot of things happening here involving Jackrabbit baseball.
Yeah, I mean, that early series was, when I look back on our season, that was just kind of one of our hiccups. And Northern Colorado surely played well, and they played better than we did in that series. But we were disappointed with how we pitched, especially in that series. So looking forward to getting them back here on our home turf. And like you said, if we have a good weekend this weekend, we can begin to look forward to that tournament and try to set up our pitching. Going to NDSU in the final weekend, that's it's not ideal if you have to go up there and win a series or win a few games at their place. So it's a big weekend for us, and we haven't played much at home, and we surely haven't played much at on campus. So we're hopeful to give those seniors a send off for senior day on Saturday, and just finish the home stretch in a good spot.